Hi friends, welcome back to my channel PU Zone. Myself Priya. Today I am going to discuss about section 11 of Civil Procedure Code, that is res judicata. Res judicata is discussed under section 11 of Civil Procedure Code, which means once the matter is decided by the competent court, then no person is permitted to reopen it in the subsequent litigation. The object of res judicata is based on three maxims. The first one is, no man should be vexed twice for the same cause. The second one is, it is in the interest of the state that there should be an end to litigation. The third one is, a judicial decision must be accepted as correct. Conditions for the application of res judicata. The first one is, there must be two suits, one the former and the other one is subsequent. Former suit means the previously decided suit. It doesn't matter when the suit was initiated, but it matters when the suit was decided. The second one is, the matter should be directly and substantially in the subsequent suit. It means that the matter should be directly related to the suit. It should not be incidental to the issue. A and her mother filed a suit against her father's brother for the share in the property of her mother. But A can file a subsequent suit for the marriage expenses, because marriage expenses was not directly related to the former suit. So she can file a suit for her marriage expenses. The third condition is parties to the suit. The parties to the suit are those whose name appears on the record of the suit at the time of decision. A minor who is not represented by the guardian is not considered as a party. When a court decides in favor of or against the party, then the legal heirs are also considered as a party. For example, when a person files a suit for the recovery of possession and ownership, and if the court decides in his favor, then the legal heirs are also called as party after the person's death. The fourth condition is, there must be same title. Same title means in the same capacity. For example, A filed a suit against B for the ownership of the property and the suit was dismissed by the court. But A again files a suit against B as a mortgagee, which is considered as a different capacity and which is a valid suit. The fifth condition is, decision should be made by the competent court. The decision should be made by the competent court which has jurisdictions. The competent court which do not have jurisdictions, then res judicata will not apply. The sixth condition is, matter should be heard and finally decided. The matter directly and substantially in issue in subsequent suit should be heard and finally decided in the former suit. The matter is deemed to be finally decided even if the former suit is disposed of in the following manner: by ex parte, by dismissal, by oath, by decree on an award, by dismissal owing to plaintiff who has failed to produce the evidence at the time of hearing. So this much regarding the information on res judicata. If you like the video, then please subscribe to my channel and please click on bell icon for further notifications. Thank you.